is Dr. Daniel Pozarski here with Dr. Dan's Health and Business Power Hour. Today we are here with Pam Bradow from, Pam Bradow from Glacial Peak Cryotherapy, actually just right across the street. And she's going to talk to us today about how cryotherapy increases your health and what exactly her cryotherapy spa is and what it does and how she found it. Pam, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. So, is this your first podcast?
No, this is actually my second.
Oh, it's your second.
Yeah,
oh.
I'm a seasoned veteran.
You are. You are definitely.
I'm still nervous.
That's good. You should be nervous.
Yeah.
That's what I've heard.
You
should be nervous.
There's a little something wrong with you there. Thank you for trusting me. That's what I say.
Yes, totally. So tell us a little bit about cryotherapy and how you came to find it, how you found it.
I'm retired now. I'm a dental hygienist. And
oh, yeah, that's right.
Accidents, and I recovered from the first one back in 93.
What kind of accidents?
I was a pedestrian in a car accident on a very busy street in Everett, Washington.
Oh.
Leaving a dental hygiene meeting. I was yelling at my friends not to jaywalk on this busy street. I'm in the crosswalk with my pedestrian light saying, come on ahead, let's walk. And a guy on a red took it.
Oh, my goodness.
I fell on his windshield and landed on the ground and didn't lose consciousness, but I think the police officer that did my report, I cleaned his teeth not too long ago, so I remembered him. And different people, it's like, lady, lose consciousness so we can just take care of you. I want to go to this hospital. No, never mind, I'm a mile or a block away from another hospital. It was just an interesting, bad car accident. Thankfully, I did not have my infant son with me. He was 5.5 months old. So, needless to say, I was severely concussed and a lot of soft tissue issues.
Mm-hmm.
But I managed to recover back then in the early 90s. It wasn't much of...
They didn't do a lot for recovery or...
I did the chiropractic and I did some... I did more of the pain pill route and the Flexerol and the... And I was doped up. I would work a day of dental hygiene when I was recovered, so to speak, and I'd be passed out on the floor playing with my child, passed out with Flexerol on board because I hurt so dang bad the next day. So that was not really a graceful recovery or a productive recovery. So I feel like there was maybe something lingering. But anyway, I recovered. But fast forward to July.
How long did it take to recover?
Oh, years. Because I just had him in March of 93, and I had this accident in September, October, and I don't think I did well for a whole year.
Yeah, it usually takes at least a year, in my experience, with patients that I treat to heal as completely as possible.
And they never really, when I went to the emergency room, they didn't really address my concussion. I landed, so I was by a corner lot where they were washing the cars off from the dust and the whatever of the day, the dew of the day. So I landed in a puddle of water. I had a very vibrant plaid blazer jacket on because I dressed up for this meeting. And how could this driver miss me? I mean, I was like, wow. In the 90s, it was the fluorescent multicolored blazer. But I had scun my left foot because I landed down on that, but then my head fell back like a ping pong.
Yeah.
And I hit the right quarter panel, so to speak, of my back occipital lobe area, temporal occipital. And so what is this back here? That's occipital.
Occipital.
But anyway, don't want to get too technical.
Get close to the temporal parietal region.
Right. There you go. But I was bleeding, but they didn't really address my wounds. I went home and passed out with pain. So Mm-hmm. They didn't really do much. But needless to say, my son quit nursing because I was so in pain mm-hmm. and drugged out that I didn't probably taste good anymore. So
He stopped.
And that was very sad. I was very emotionally distraught because I couldn't work. My son gave me up. I was a new mom. I hurt. Mm-hmm. And so that one was a really hard accident to recover from. But 4 years later, I was well enough to have another baby. Mm-hmm. I just had a lot of hip and neck and, you know.
It hangs on if you don't get it treated correctly.
I did a lot of cranial sacral. I had a great massage therapist back then. She gave you everything she had. Mm-hmm. So we did a lot of cranial sacral, the myofascial release. And so that was painful sometimes with not those necessarily, but some of the therapies that she kind of ran me through was helpful. But oof, it rocked
the world. What I found with the auto injuries is it's mostly muscle tissue, soft tissue injury, and myofascial release is one of the things that works the best.
Yep.
Along with, like, we do a lot of like physical, well, we can't call it physical therapy, but therapeutic exercise here, and then we also use massage therapists, and I do a lot of tissue work and myofascial release, and then like the manipulation, like with that also helps to decrease the pressure on the nervous system.
Well, what I felt in my body, and I felt again in my second accident, but the trauma, the protective stance that your body goes to protect from hitting the head on the asphalt again, because I popped up off the tar like a ping pong, and I caught myself so I wouldn't fall back and hit it again so hard. So that clamped me down. I had this much room between my hip bone, an inch or two, between my hip and my rib cage. So I was clamped down. Oh, I was crooked. I was walking crooked.
Yeah. So
anyway, but yeah. But then that thoracic inlet, and then my dental profession, you know, I'm hovering over you, getting close. My posture was compromised in that profession anyway, so you had to have good core strength. Uh-huh. Well, my core strength was shot. Uh-huh. And then to try and recover and to strengthen that back up again so that I could handle it several patients a day and not feel fagged out by the end and the next day to recover. So That was just a, oh man, what a distant memory. I'm so glad I had a different experience with this accident, just because I was, July, the end of July, it's coming up on 4 years, well, right. 5 years. Mm-hmm. My daughter and I were going to some friends for a housewarming party, and Colorado Springs has a lot of three-lane streets.
Yeah, I've been there once. It's a lot like Fargo, actually.
Yeah.
So far, the mountains. Yep.
So, like, imagine 32nd, mm-hmm. you know, but then the median had more of a boulevard effect. So there were trees in the boulevard in the mm-hmm. in the median, and so there was a right turn lane, and I was in the left travel straight lane, and there were roundabouts, and this was a cross intersection that I came up off of or onto, and this lady came across the three lanes going west or east, and I didn't see it coming because the boulevard was there and the trees. There's a berm, kind of like on Veterans, where mm-hmm. there's that mm-hmm. dome. And my daughter was a passenger. We were talking, but I was going maybe 35, 40, and she hit me in the front panel. Excuse my timer. She hit me in the front quarter panel of my car, mm-hmm. and I was on the inside lane. I crossed over two lanes and was now, and then she hit me in the back quarter panel on the driver's side.
Oh, she hit you, then she like swung into you?
Yeah, she hit me in the front, bam, stopped me, and then she hit me again. She went over to the stop sign from the oncoming traffic out of that neighborhood, and I went into the neighborhood. Oh. So I crossed three lanes of traffic, went into the neighborhood on that street that she was crossing.
Yeah, and it's usually like one side that's in every accident, there's one side of the body that's more injured than the other side. That's what I found every single accident.
Okay, that makes sense. So I was impacted on my driver's side, my left side. Mm-hmm. I hit my knee somehow on the dash or something, mm-hmm. my left knee. But again, it was my right side that was. I was so concussed. I was running into door jams, and bad.
So you hit your head? Did you hit your head?
I have no idea.
Yeah, a lot of
my daughter
don't
hit
remember.
The head on the windshield, even though all the airbags deployed. But we were. I've never had airbags deploy, and it smells like your car's on fire.
Oh, really?
I'm screaming at her, "Get out of the car! It's on fire!" You know, and she's like, "What are you talking about, Mom?" I'm like, "I don't know." So, yeah. Anyway, I've been in that other accident. I go to the doctor just to go in the ambulance. I didn't want to, but I needed to get x-rays to make sure my whiplash wasn't more mm-hmm. and that my leg wasn't more because mm-hmm. it could have been broken. Mm-hmm. It was a bad impact. And my neck and shoulder, I needed to. So it was a waste of time, money, and energy, but yet it was a necessary evil, especially for the insurance things that you have to jump
yeah.
to. But I wanted to rule it out, so I didn't go home and wake up the next morning saying, I should have gone, you know?
Yeah, I recommend that everybody goes and get an x-ray.
Right? So I got my x-rays, and my daughter was younger, bounced back a lot easier.
Mm-hmm.
But I couldn't drive for a while. I took some time off from work, and then I tried part-time, like, 4 patients a day instead of 8 to 10, mm-hmm. and I couldn't keep up. I couldn't focus in their mouth. I thought I was falling out of my chair.
Mm.
That
so you
vertigo.
Bad whiplash.
Yep. So I was starting my therapies: chiropractic, acupuncture, the quasha.
Quasha, yeah.
Yep. Laser treatment, cold laser treatment on mm-hmm. the larynx, or the neck. Corrective vision with the prism glasses.
Oh, you did that even?
I did that.
I do that for like TBIs a lot.
And I went to a neuro feedback psychologist.
Mm-hmm.
And that helped a lot. And I was doing the concussion specialist chiropractor in my regular. I mean, I was doctored up, ma'am.
Yeah.
And then my massage therapist said, well, why don't you try cryo? Because I felt like I'm coming to you and I'm good for 2 minutes, and then by the time I get home, I'm already crooked again and hurting.
Mm-hmm.
So she said, they just opened up, try it. And I'm like, well. But, you yeah. know, in my recovery, you know, I was making gains, and then I'd plateau, and then I'd make gains again, and then I'd plateau or regress, and I would be depressed and frustrated. So that was kind of where I was at. So I'm like, great, now you want me to take another appointment, spend more money, and probably get nowhere further along. Mm-hmm. And but I saw them on the news then. I did wait a while because I think she told me mid-October, and November 4th was my first visit.
It's a cryotherapy spa.
Yep. And I could tell that this one muscle on my right neck shoulder,
it's
was
like the trap.
Yeah,
leader.
The top of my trap.
Yep.
And it was quivering. It wasn't releasing.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't. You know, you're healed.
Yeah.
It was quivering, like, I kind of like that, but I don't trust it. And I uh-huh. know from my other accident, you had to build trust in redirecting your muscle memory to forget the accident,
mm-hmm.
forget that protective stance that kept you out of alignment or adjustment.
Mm-hmm.
You had to disturb that communication of you're going to be in danger if you don't.
Yeah, that's what you hear is retrain
so
all
that
the supporting
we're
muscles.
Retraining,
so those
yeah. And that's why the massage, that's why mm-hmm. we do the electrical stimulus to try and break mm-hmm. that pain-brain communication so you mm-hmm. can say, let it go, it's okay, you're mm-hmm. safe now. No, that was not working for me. Neurofeedback, the laser treatments, I was still.
Yep.
So I tried this and it was quivering. And I'm like, okay, this is encouraging.
Mm-hmm.
I gotta see what this is gonna do further. So I signed up to do it daily.
Oh, you did daily.
Yep,
first.
I did it daily. And So I found it November 4th. By my fourth visit, I was thinking, I can retire from dental hygiene. I wanted to move back to the Fargo area to do dental hygiene, but I thought, how, my kids are in college now. I need to work. I'm not going to stay here in Colorado because I'm here alone. Mm-hmm. And I want to go back to my family, closer to my family. And my procedures, my documents to get licensed here in North Dakota, Minnesota, were on my desk. And by that fourth visit, I threw that away.
Oh, really?
And I started studying cryo and made some trips to Texas.
Yeah, so is that where they do the training?
That is where excuse me, I got a tickle. I use the Juka sauna. It's a European model.
Or where it's a whole room?
No. I use the stand-up sauna. They use a cryomed sauna. Stand-up sauna. Mm-hmm. And it's like mine, but it was made in the U.S. down in Texas.
Oh, okay.
So I made the trip down to their cryomed headquarters in Dallas, Texas. So I talked to them a little bit and was looking into buying their units as well. And hung out with them. They let me shadow them because I wasn't going to be in direct competition in Fargo, North Dakota.
Yeah.
And so by the time in December, I made a trip to Texas. And then in January, I came here looking for a location to mm-hmm. build out my unit and start ordering and getting stuff lined up. With another trip to Texas then, and then my move out here. I sold my house in Colorado, packed up everything, found my location, started. I was back here by the end of March. Recovered from, so with the cryotherapy, doing it daily, I was making more headway with my recovery. My adjustments seemed to hold better.
Yep.
My corrective vision, you know, and it could have been coincidence. It's hard to measure what cryo actually does because, mm-hmm. and it's hard to test.
What does it actually do?
Oh my gosh, it is amazing. So it just triggers that fight or flight response. We expose your body, as much skin as possible, that's why you're minimally clothed,
mm-hmm.
to my extreme cold temperatures. And it's 190 to 240 below. I have it calibrated to 240. I can go colder, but
max that you can do?
I've gone down to 320.
Oh, really?
When I was in Colorado, we played with that. You know what? It's just there's no extra benefit therapeutically, and it's just awfully darn painful.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it gets a lot more painful during that time. So, lady wants to say hi. Because we were playing around with that in Colorado.
I see.
Yeah, and I'm like, I think I wanted people to have a positive experience.
Yes.
And I'm already testing their
limits.
Yeah. So, but therapeutically, this is 166 is the triggering temperature where your body is saying, okay, Daniel, dang, you are in danger. So
there's a sympathetic response.
Yep. So it triggers your brain to say, holy cow, buddy, let's bring your long track of your circulatory system to the short track.
Mm-hmm.
So it brings all your peripheral fluids.
Everything constricts.
To your core. And there it's protecting your core, keeping your vitals vital
mm-hmm.
during this time. It doesn't know you're getting it out in 2 to 3 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And the threat is real. So your brain is like, holy crap. And you know what our winters are like. So you're like, oh, it's starting to bite. It's starting to nip. You're in a controlled environment. It's not going to frostbite you.
I've not been there long enough. I've tried to recreate it with going out on my deck in the wintertime in my boxers.
Yeah. And that's worse, actually. Because there's humidity in the air.
Yeah.
And in my sauna, there's no humidity. And the wind chill.
Yeah.
Those two factors really get you.
And I've done ice baths, and you can't get your skin temperature
down low enough either. And you have to stay in there longer, so therefore then your muscles and everything starts to cramp up and cool off. And then there's a recovery process.
Mm-hmm.
Where mine, it's instant. So the minute this this sympathetic response happens, and mm-hmm. your blood is at your core protecting it. It's doing what it's already wanting to do on the long track when it's all, the circulation's all out there, but it's just being a little more focused. It's filtering your blood, cleansing your organs, oxygen rich, enzyme rich. It's just fortifying. It's just more hyperactive. It's not getting clogged in your hip area. It's not getting clogged mm-hmm. up in your elbow. It's just right there, just going. So the minute that temperature shuts off, you know, the sauna shuts off, your brain is like, all right, we're back. So then you're safe. The threat is not there. That nutrient-rich blood goes back out to the extremities. And there, it can handle what it's wanting to do. It feeds your cells, and it takes out the garbage. But if your blood is so clogged up and congested and funked up, it can't be as helpful in that feeding and taking out the garbage mm-hmm. of your cells.
It seems like a really, like a detox, like when I do it. All your blood vessels constrict. I'm pretty used to it now. At first it was cold, but like, you know you're getting out
in
2 minutes.
So then yes, you constrict for that 2 to 3 minutes, but then it vasodilates.
Yeah.
You're only cold half a millimeter deep into your skin.
Yes.
So your muscles and everything are still warm. And some people actually get kind of flushed. Like, mm-hmm. ooh, that readiness, or, you know, it's like, wow, I really feel warm. So people with poor circulation mm-hmm. That are always cold, layering up, thinking, oh, I don't want to get it. This can help them with that poor circulation. You know, they're always cold.
So maybe with like thyroid issues and things like that can be helpful with.
This helps balance your hormonal issues, your metabolism. It helps elevate your mood because you get an endorphin rush.
Mm-hmm.
You're burning 800 calories in there.
Oh, you are.
It's not just in that 1, 2, 3 minute time. It helps boost your metabolism, so you're burning it over that next 2 to 3 days.
So I believe it like activates your brown adipose tissue, or your brown fat,
mm-hmm.
it's like what little babies have.
So
that's what increases metabolism.
Right. So if you do this regularly, your yellow fat does turn to brown fat, so then it's digested in your lymph mm-hmm. system better.
Mm-hmm.
And is just, you know, so you can lose weight. You have to be exercising. You have to be eating right, and being kind of a little proactive on it. You can't expect this to do everything. Just like you don't expect this to, and I don't expect cryotherapy to heal people and to not need the physical therapists, the chiropractors, the other doctors, but for surgery. You still may need surgery, but we can get you ready for surgery.
Mm-hmm.
Help a better blood flow to that area so that you can handle the surgery better and recover
Recovery
from it.
Recovery is huge. Well, it's huge in like professional sports mm-hmm. now. You were talking to me before the Redhawks come in.
Yeah, they're back in town. It's good to have the boys back.
Yes. I want to go out to a baseball game this summer. I haven't been to one in a couple of years, but I've been
good
so busy.
Beer, good
just
time.
Need practice.
Yep.
So what are some of the like interesting cases that you've seen, like things that in the last 4 years that have cleared up, or like positive stories?
One lady, she came from the cycle bar. She rides a bike there. She's walking in with a cane. She had some edema,
mm-hmm.
so to speak. It hurt to walk in her legs. She left carrying her cane.
Oh, wow.
So that was kind of fun.
Oh, that's
like,
cool.
Oh, wonder what happened. And then I had a lady up north, northern Minnesota area. I get a lot of people that travel in.
Really?
Oh, yeah. I've pulled people from Montana, Roseau.
So you literally went in North Dakota?
That was the first one in North Dakota.
Okay.
The one up in Grand Forks did just recently close, I think.
Oh, did?
Due to COVID, possibly, and I don't know. We've talked some, but it's her story, not mine.
Did they have the same type of machine? Or?
She had a different machine than what I do, but she had the same. They kind of run off the same. So they're just a different manufacturer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Around the same way.
Yeah, and she was busy with CrossFit, so she was wanting to pursue that more and choose an athlete. I'm not. But
yeah, yours is more of a spa atmosphere. I think the atmosphere is a lot different in your office or
I clinic. Wanted to create a nice place for both men and women to come alike. Mm-hmm. I wanted to be multi-generational. I wanted to help the older people. Mm-hmm. Today I had an MS person come in. She's got MS and she's now using a walker, a roller walker. Mm-hmm. And she has tried my Normatec compression therapy with her edema and in her ankles. But mm-hmm. she was asking about my cryo sauna. And I was going to tell you about one lady that came from northern Minnesota. She came in kind of hunched over, just hurting. She's got MS as well. And she goes, Pam, I went home, I washed the floor on my hands and knees, I made a batch of cookies, I felt great. So it helps with that inflammation. It doesn't take that MS away, you still have it, but it lessens the inflammation so you have more mobility. It slows that process down.
And probably stimulated her nervous system a little bit also.
Right.
To respond so she could do some of that stuff. I know it works awesome for me in the summer here when I have really bad allergies.
Yes.
Because I have severe allergies and going in the sauna and getting the facials just feel amazing.
Oh my gosh. That's a game changer.
Yeah, that's like my favorite part.
She has shingles. She goes, Pam. I said, are your allergies acting up? She goes, nope. Today it's shingles. So gave her a facial and kind of hit her shingle spot extra hard. Uh-huh. And I say that. In jest, I'm not hitting her hard.
Yes.
I'm gentle. I'm loving and kind. But I paid more closer attention. So when you come in for a facial, I do take into account that if you have neck or shoulder strains or a migraine, I'm going to address the back wherever your migraine is. If it's a cluster on the right side mm-hmm. or the back of the neck, I'll concentrate more on that. If you've got cystic acne, I'll work on that acne area. We'll do the whole thing, but accentuate those areas that you have issue with.
Focus on the on the problem areas. I think it's good that you get the whole neck and head because then you're hitting the lymph system and everything can drain out of there.
Right.
That
right.
works really good.
So when people come in, so when I do the facial, I'm doing the whole head and neck, but I'll accentuate those areas of concern. So when people come in with a tweaked knee or an elbow or a twisted ankle, it's like, oh, I just want a local treatment. I don't want to. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, okay, I can do that. But I want you to get, you're compensating in your gait, in your, in your stance. I'm wanting to take all that memory of that accident or whatever has brought you to this point, take it down a notch and give you a systemic flush of rejuvenating circulation, and then I'll hit you or give you a shot of that local treatment just to ice pack it down further.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So it still does that surface cold but vasodilation, so it brings a healthier blood flow to that area mm-hmm. to take out the garbage and feed that and promote that healing.
So describe to the listeners, it's a facial but you're not actually touching their face.
No, good point. Yes, I'm blowing air over your scalp, face, neck, and décolleté. And mm-hmm. I'm blowing 250 to 300 below zero air.
Yeah, it's kind of like a vacuum hose is sort of what it's
It looks like a vacuum hose.
Yeah.
But I'm blowing air instead of sucking air.
Yes.
And I can adjust my intensity of the airflow to be, a little forceful in thicker-haired people. Especially on the scalp. So we're taking the inflammation out of your skin. So rosacea, eczema, psoriasis, even the hair follicles. We can take the inflammation out so that we can allow your hair follicles to breathe.
Oh, wow.
So you can't bring the dead ones back. Thinning hair. We can help thicken. My daughter is lucky because I am her mom. For one thing. I know. But she gets to use a lot of these services. And she donates a lot of hair, grows it out. She's got
She does.
So she noticed a thicker ponytail, and it grew faster, because she hated to donate so too much, had to grow it out longer so she wouldn't be short haired then anyway, it's, so people notice a thicker ponytail, and I had recently, over Christmas time, New Year's time, I had an older gentleman who had more of a chicken neck and thinning hair. He was in his 60s, and gave him a couple facials and a couple whole bodies in about 21 days, and you can tell a difference in his hair thickening up on his temples, and just the skin brightening up and firming up. We're not just what are we doing? We're killing the enzymes that are breaking down the collagen and elastin in the skin.
Oh, you are.
Yep.
So we're flushing them out, or
we're so as we age, our collagen breaks down, right? Mm-hmm. Those enzymes are breaking down our collagen. Mm-hmm. So if we're killing, and enzymes can be helpful to digest things, but it's breaking down our vitality. So
yes,
if we can break down those enzymes that are breaking down our collagen, that's allowing the collagen to build and to keep firm. So he's looking good.
And then on that note, you also do stuff for, I saw weddings.
Yes.
Like wedding season.
Yes. And just for moms that have had babies that really want their bodies back.
Yeah.
So it's the cryo T-shock.
Yeah, that's the new thing that you have.
Yeah. And I've had it for a little while here, but timing and promoting it is just another thing, and getting people to work with me to help provide the services. But it is a little bit more time consuming of a service. But we're using more of an ultrasound wand.
Yep.
With thermally compatible gel that we heat up the area.
Mm-hmm.
So when we're working an area, when we're doing your abdomen, it's not one section on the right side, one section on the left. It's right and left, bilateral. And we're doing an area, and we heat up the area with a few minutes of warm, kind of getting the cell saying, hey, what are we going to do today? Hi, I'm showing up. And then we zap it with the cold. And we are cold for about 20, 25 minutes on each side, manipulating it.
And that helps shrink the yellow fat cells, I believe.
It's killing the fat cells.
Or kills the fat cells.
Mm-hmm. And again, too, we're also helping stimulate healthier tissue and breaking down the... Because with weight loss comes the sagier, baggier skin.
Yep.
And if we can firm that up and get the enzymes to die off so that the collagen and elastin can build, that's helpful for that.
Oh, okay.
So, that makes sense. And so then at the end, then after that cold snap, then we heat it up again. This is the fat burning one. And then we're waking up the lymphatic system. We're not waking it all up, but we're just kind of getting it all, okay, now you can start the digestive process.
What's a treatment plan like for a beginner?
So if we're doing your abdomen today, it takes 2 weeks to totally digest and let that digestion happen.
Oh, it does.
So we can't do your abs again until 2 weeks out. But we can do, and we can't do legs and arms or legs and tummy or back and tummy, because that's too much of a dump into your lymphatic system.
Mm-hmm.
So we'd overload it and it wouldn't be as effective. So what we do is we do your abs this week.
Mm-hmm.
Next week you can come back and we can do your love handles,
mm-hmm.
lower back or your legs. And then the following week then your abs will be ready. So we can do your abs again. Or some people have done their legs and then a facial. And the facial, that one I can do 2 in one day, just because your face doesn't have a lot of fat. It's a little bit more with this. Just to take off that puffiness.
Yeah, and they're really...
Yeah.
I don't know what the word is. Finicky about that.
I'm looking at
Their shows are coming up in the fall.
And
then with the corona, other things are canceled. How's it been through that?
Quiet, a little quiet.
A little quiet.
I did close down in April. Just for precautionary... And just kind of figure out what I needed to do next. So, opened it up slowly in May, but I think the whole town was slow.
Yeah.
I was beginning to take it personally, and I'm like, wait a minute, Pam, everybody's freaking out, so settle down.
Yeah, every small business is
right.
struggling.
And
then it's summer in Fargo.
Yeah, and then the legs.
Yep.
And so, but right now, like we were talking earlier, everybody thinks, oh, I'm going to try it when it's warmer out.
Yeah.
But your body temperature's hot or warmer. Mm-hmm. And so it takes a little bit more to get you cold. And yeah, so it's.
So it's like jumping in cold water when you're hot.
Yeah.
Or warm blooded.
Yeah.
So then it's going to be a little bit more of a shock.
So. There's no air, there's no moisture in my sauna, and the wind chill is less. You know, it's a drier cold,
mm-hmm.
and you're not getting wet, and that's what I like about it. And it's fast and easy. That's one thing with my recovery. You know, the massage therapist takes an hour and a half. The adjustments sometimes take half an hour, you know, or mm-hmm. acupuncture therapies, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, I don't have more time in my day for yet another appointment to just mm-hmm. be discouraged. So I was really happy that it was only 2 to 3 minutes, and the first few times I felt like I had more energy, yes, but I also was doing some toxic dumping, so yep. there was an overlay of fatigue, and I'm like, oh, but I was getting better rest.
Yeah.
I was able to get, you know, you can go to bed, but you can't guarantee a good night's rest.
Mm-hmm.
I was getting there, and that's what your body wants when mm-hmm. it's trying to recover from an accident.
Yeah, every time I've over there, I always sleep a lot better that night.
And sometimes you wake up ahead of your alarm, and I was like, oh, that never happens.
So. I had that experience a couple weeks ago. And like, I was like, I haven't done that in years.
Yeah. Come on over more often. Yes. You can do that every day.
Yes.
Especially Mondays, right?
Yeah. Yep. Monday.
So.
Or the end of the week. That's when it gets
yeah.
harder.
And that nutrient-rich blood does linger in your body for about 48 to 72 hours.
Yep, that's what it
feels
like.
Depending upon your toxicity. So you... And this is training people to listen to their bodies, because we're not trained to do
mm-hmm.
that.
Mm-hmm.
We're told, suck it up and deal. Take a Tylenol.
That's Midwest, yeah.
Yep. I grew up on a farm, I know.
Yep.
My dad did. And
yep.
that's why I wanted to move back, to help these people that are walking crooked now, because they sucked it up and dealt with it.
Or their normal pain. I hate that.
Yeah.
That's my.
Oh, I know.
I hate, that is my pet peeve. Like, oh, I'm just back to my normal
pain. I'm always
pain.
In pain. I'm like,
yeah. Mm-hmm. It's not normal.
So
you
when
have
you
to be.
Are seeing a relief, and then you see it kind of creep back at you, that's time.
Yeah,
to
then they
in.
Start to know their proprioception of their bodies has come back.
So if we're dealing with acute issues, yeah, a couple of sessions, you're going to feel back and good. But if it's an acute over a chronic thing or something, I do
mm-hmm.
like to have like a month unlimited, a couple of them. Just so you can come daily or every other day at least
mm-hmm.
to just get on top of it. Give that body that break that it needs. Build up the trust in your cells
mm-hmm.
to recover. And then keep going with your therapies, because they're going to help you stay. And then as I was feeling better in my 4 to... Because I found it in November and I was gone in March to open my own business. That's
5 months. Yeah, that's super fast.
Yeah, so that sped up my recovery. It could have been a coincidence, but yet it was pretty exciting, because I felt better, because
mm-hmm.
I did it daily, and then I could tell when I... So then I'd take a trip down to the cities and get a shot or a session down there. So.
Oh, there. So you would do it... You would go there first before you opened
when
there.
When I moved back here, I had to build out my space. It was dirt floor in that building.
Yeah, yeah. It was. It
so
wasn't
I,
like it was, four years ago, it wasn't allowed here.
Right. So I built that out. So in that time, I was burning the candle at both ends again. And
mm-hmm.
So
I know
I
what that's like.
Down to the cities to just kind of get rebooted.
Is there a couple places down there then?
Yes. So, Theory of Champions, Brandon, he was with The Locker. He
mm-hmm.
sold his part off and did Theory of Champions. He's more with the Timberwolves, the Vikings, the
mm-hmm.
athletes. They're also doing another type of therapy. I'm not even
so like
mention
infrared?
That. Yeah, something like that.
Deep infrared
yeah.
beds? I've seen those that go with the cryo stuff.
Yeah. Oh, no, this was a little bit more... It was an acronym, and I'm bad at acronyms, so I'm not even going to try.
Okay.
And then the Halo has several locations. I think he kind of mini-franchised out himself
oh.
to Maple Valley, Edina. Wayzata.
Oh, okay.
He's got a couple locations down there. So.
And they all use that same Juca machine? Or is it just cryotherapy?
Brandon did with Theory of Champions. I'm not sure what Halo does. His is a different machine that I'm not familiar with.
Oh, okay. Have you ever seen those? Like I know like Tony Robbins and stuff like have those rooms that they sit in. Sort of like.
So what they're doing is they're using maybe electricity or liquid nitrogen to chill the walls of the room.
Uh-huh.
So you're not my sauna, we elevate your head so you're breathing oxygenated air, room air.
Yeah.
Because if you were in that sauna, you would pass out because it's pure nitrogen air.
Yeah,
we
that's
have
true.
Nitrogen in our air, but yet it's calibrated right. So in those rooms where that you can go in and be totally immersed or submersed or whatever, they're just chilling the room to that cold temperature.
Oh, and they're just
the
walking around
with
in
the
park.
Gas. So, and there's electrical units. My dream was to maybe have a mobile unit and say, hey, and be more electrical or like in a motorhome. Mondays in Minot and Wednesdays in Williston or something. You know,
sounds like a lot of work.
I'm realizing it. I'm better versed right here. I do get my people pulled in from Minot, Williston.
Yeah.
Out there, Newtown.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Bowman, Dickinson.
Wow.
So.
I didn't know people travel that far.
Yep, Aberdeen, Sioux Falls. So.
Yeah, I'll get people from a couple hours away. But I won't get people from that far usually.
Right. And so I try to package my product, my services, in ways that are conducive to help those that are further out. In Colorado, everybody was pretty much, it's a bigger town, everybody was pretty much there. There were some people that came down from Denver and whatever, I want to be able to accommodate those people that do have to travel and make it not expire too fast. But
do they usually stay for a couple of days then?
So, like my Newtown couple, they came over Thanksgiving, and I said, okay, normally closed, but I don't have big plans. My kids are gone right now, so I'll stay late. I'll come back in when they got into town. Gave them a session, and then I don't know if we came back Thursday, but I did come back Friday and Saturday, and then we hit them again Sunday before they left for home.
Oh, okay.
So I was working with them a little bit. I was open Friday, Saturday anyway, so they just came in, but I tried to accommodate them as they came into town.
Are you open Saturdays now?
Yep.
Okay, good. It's good to know.
Yep.
A lot of people work all week, and so they can't, especially construction.
Yes, so I do get a lot of my cement workers, my truck drivers.
Farmers.
Yep, farmers.
They usually come in on Saturdays. They like Saturdays a lot. That's why I'm open on Saturdays.
Yeah, yeah.
Then I take Mondays off.
Oh, well, see, I don't. That's different.
Yeah, it's a little bit different. Anything else? Do you want to talk about like what an initial package would be or what you offer for first-time newcomers?
First-timers come in. I offer a two-for-one, two for the price of one, and I put a little bit of a time frame on my intro packs just so you get a two-pack, two for 60, and you spread them apart 6 months, and I don't really notice anything. So that's just for my novice, hey, let's try it type of person. The first one is the fear factor session, and the second one, your body knows what to expect, so it's a little more relaxed, and it receives the process a lot better.
Yeah, that's what I found, too.
Yep. So that's my two-pack, and then if you complete those two within the week, you get a free complimentary Normatec session, which is the compression session.
What does that work best for?
That is just good to just people with cankles, poor circulation and blood return. So I have 9-year-olds coming in for that. I have 10-year-olds, young athletes with growing pains coming in for that. So we can, the compressors are calibrated so I can adjust the intensity. Today I had a MS lady, one out of 10. And that was enough for her.
Yeah,
but it helped that lymph.
Sensitivity.
Yep. But then my athletes, they give me a 10, but I'm like, wait a minute. But if you have an injury or something, 10. We'll work our way up to a 10 if it feels good, but we don't want you to scare it so you go into a protective stance. Yeah. We want this to be a relaxing, rejuvenating experience, mm-hmm. not a, oh my gosh.
Do you get people with like heart failure or anything like that? Like,
those are a contraindication. Both so, yeah, if you have congestive heart failure, heart issues, mm-hmm. that you're not cleared for exercise, mm-hmm. you can come in if you have controlled high blood pressure. Mm-hmm. This will help reduce it. Just let your doctor know because you may have to change your medication.
Oh, yeah, because it will increase it.
Especially if you're going to do this for a period of time with any medication that you're taking, be it a multivitamin supplement, you may not need as much.
Yeah.
Just because you're not trying to feed a toxic system. You're feeding a, you know, you're fortifying a healthier system that doesn't require so much. You don't need to oversaturate. So then I have, so back to my intro packs, I have a 5-pack for my people that have more of a chronic nagging something or need a little bit longer time.
Yeah, that's what I got for the summer.
Yeah, and it's great for just a young athlete that has an acute sprain or sprain.
Mm-hmm.
That one, you have a month to use the 5, and it's for the price of 2, so it's 120.
Mm-hmm.
You have a month to use it, so you double up. So you can use that as much as you want. I like to double up that first week, get 2 sessions in at least on that first week,
mm-hmm.
just to kind of give you a jump start. It's like the Z-Pack antibiotics. Yeah. You know, you take a couple,
yeah.
and then...
Take 5 in a row, yeah. and then...
So then...
Lean off of them.
Yep. And then if you finish all 5, then you get a free Normatec as well with that.
Oh.
But okay. That's a little bit of an incentive to finish it within that 5.
Mm-hmm.
And they are geared just to the whole body. They're not interchangeable with facials or anything.
Okay.
But my initial facial is half price, so it's $30.
Okay.
That's a nice little way to test it and see. And it's not just for the ladies.
Everybody that I love it. And then anybody that I've ever talked to that's had it done has just really loved it.
People have come
feels great.
Migraines.
That's why I was in there like beginning of the month. I was in there, I think, for a migraine. Because I usually don't get migraines, but I don't get adjusted as much anymore either.
Because you're not with other guys.
Yeah, I need to get another doctor in here. But that helped me. That cleared it, pretty much cleared it up.
Yeah.
And then I got adjusted the next day and I was good to go.
So, if you are wanting to try cryotherapy, I get some athletes that like to try and come in after a workout. Their body is hot. They don't come in after their body's naturally cooled down.
Mm-hmm.
We could run you. It's going to be harder to get you down to my temperature range that I want to get your skin temperature down to.
Mm-hmm.
It's not going to be as therapeutic. Let your body naturally cool down because then you get the best of your workout
yeah,
and then the best of my cryo.
That makes sense.
And if you have time,
like
you
can
do the cryo before your workout. What my athletes are doing, like after practices all week, they come, like my force guys, I had one that worked for me. He would skate all week. Wednesday night, he would definitely jump in, and then it would give him gas for the games,
mm-hmm.
Thursday, and their travel, Thursday, Friday,
mm-hmm.
Saturday. So that's kind of how... But if you're gonna work out today, and you should I do cryo before or after? Do it before. It's gonna
mm-hmm.
give you extra zip in your
yeah.
workout, and it's gonna linger in your system long enough for a better recovery.
I thought about that.
Yeah.
I'll remember that.
Yeah, because I had one of the Red Hawks come in today, and he goes, "Oh, I just came in from the working out," and I'm like, "So you're kind of hot," and I said, well, do you want to go eat something? He goes, yeah, actually, I'm going to go eat after this. I said, why don't you come back? Because I want you to get the best benefit of this.
Mm-hmm.
And so he came back, and he was cooled down to normal body temperature then and had some food in his tummy. Oh, two, another nice, helpful thing. So if you have like fibromyalgia, just chronic fatigue, funk, a migraine, anything that's ailing you, if you want to try cryo, come in hydrated and having eaten something.
Oh, okay.
Just because this does speed up your metabolism, and we are doing a toxic dump, but if there's nothing in your system and you're not hydrated, it can be a bit of a head rush. So people like that are very sensitive, justifiably so, but it can make them think that they're doing something wrong. So, and I've had to calm, and I felt that myself at times. But
yeah, that's why I started coming back in too, because I was starting to get burnt out, and like I was like, I gotta start taking care of myself. So
right. So the people that have been dealing with chronic crud of some sort for a period of time, please come in hydrated and having eaten something that day before, so that you're not wishing you had. I mean, we can give you a glass of water, and I do that to some of my people that, oh crap, I didn't probably drink enough today. I just got off of work, blah, blah, blah. So I give them a glass of water after they get out of the dressing room in their robe while we're waiting for the sauna to cool down, and they drink it down, and then they achieve their temperature goal. So it's a lot more effective.
And what's the temperature goal?
So normally your skin temperature, you have a temperature gun in there. You've seen me shoot you. Your normal temperature, if you're not inflamed.
Laser temperature gun.
Yes, laser. So you're normally running about 86, 87 degrees. But if you've got inflammation, it's up in the 90s, 94.
Oh, okay.
I've seen 94. But then, so in the sauna, we're just getting you cold a half a millimeter deep in your skin. So we're cooling you down to like between 30 and 50 degrees skin temperature.
Wow.
And that is cold, but you're not frostbitten yet.
Yeah, I'll get out. And I'll usually be like 41, 42.
That's my sweet zone right there, right in that 40s. Below 30, I've had people go below 30. It can be more painful.
It is.
And then we run the risk of frostbite.
Yeah.
So some people don't require the full 3 minutes. You're still getting your money's worth because we got you down to temperature.
Uh-huh.
Some people say, I want my money's worth. I'm going to stay the full 3.
Yeah, yeah.
They're like, okay, but that's not the point.
That's the way the body works.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
So we want to get you between 30 and 50. So that being said, some of my athletes, they come in hot, or some people just run hotter, warmer.
Mm-hmm.
That's not a word. So they
more hot.
So they're in the full 3 minutes, but they're still 55, 58 degrees. I've had some 65. So they've got something going on. So I let them warm up to about 75. Normally is 86, remember?
Mm-hmm.
So I let them warm up a little bit, and I put them back in for only 2 more minutes.
Oh, you do?
So I double dip them.
Oh, yeah, you're telling me about that.
Yep, I've double dipped many of Red Hawk guys and some other athletes that, you know, that are just higher octane type of thing. And so their metabolism is zinging. Some of my redheads, they run a little hotter.
Really?
Yep, I have to double dip a lot of redheads.
I know that.
So and it's just some of the nuances that I've experienced over the years. But yeah, so double dipping, it isn't awful. You warm up, so I'm not putting you at instant risk of frostbite, you know, doubling up on that. But then we get you down to about 40, and that's perfect.
Okay, great. Well, I think we can probably wrap it up from there. And again, this is Pam, how do you say that? Pam Bradow with Glacial Peak Cryotherapy, and thank you for being on our show. She's open from 12 to 5.
12 to 5 right now.
12 to 5 Monday through Saturday?
Friday.
12 to 5 Monday through Friday.
Saturday 9 to 2.
And Saturday 9 to 2. Check her out. Her phone number is 701-532-0759. I would highly recommend it for anybody that is inflamed, has injuries, allergies, or any of the topics that we talked about today. Thanks for being on the show, Pam.
Thanks for having me.
You're welcome.
Bye.
Bye-bye.